Hello internet, welcome to our new video. Today we're gonna have something amazing, something good. Have you ever wondered how to create yourself a Python desktop application? So guess what, sometimes if you love coding a lot, you don't need to install anything. If you're using Kali Linux, the new one, which is 2020.03.0.3, so what I want to say, you know, people who are much, if you're from PHP side, you would like to do this because PHP doesn't, I don't know PHP of a language which loves drag and drop. So, but anyway, there are some platforms which do design part and stuff. But if you're a PHP guy, it's much of coding. But if you're from VB, Visual Basic, it does for you much of stuff. So what I'm saying here, we're going to learn something small and just an introduction to how to create your desktop applications, or I would say with the interface things. So most people they do also most tutorials using Django, and I've seen it's much of web stuff. So now we're gonna create our own small Python stuff. So there's a lot of things which gonna come, so we're gonna cover a lot of tutorials, but today we're gonna show you without installing anything. Python is there already. Once Python is there, then you can just code and open your notepad. You type in that code, the code I'm gonna give you. After when you type it, you're gonna run it. After running it, you test and okay, you find. So now the process I'm gonna give you is a very long process, but we're gonna copy and paste for now to save time. Then in the future tutorials we're gonna make, we're gonna show you how to install tools which can help you build your interfaces without like I would say using drag and drop things, whereby you cannot code everything. You can code simple stuff, then you get your application running. So there are a couple of choices you can choose from, but some of the tutorials I've been reading, they have something which they really recommend to use, and that's the thing which we're gonna use in your it's called the PYG object. Okay, that's what they use, most of them, to use a GUI applications under Linux. So might not cover Windows, but you know why. The application we're gonna do, I'm saying the application we're gonna use, it's much also the application we're gonna use in the future tutorials it also works on Windows, I'm sure. So but there are very few development tools which don't work on Windows. That's the thing I know. So what I'm gonna do now, I'm gonna say please go to your Notepad++ or Notepad, whatever Notepad you have in Python. I'm gonna use it any text editor which is okay. I have this one here, you can see just something like this. And what we do here, I'm gonna copy a code and paste it for you. Then after pasting it there for you, you're gonna change it. If you want to change it, I got a code here. Let me see. I'm gonna call it Python GUI. Okay, I'm gonna copy the code. I'm bringing it here to you. Copy the code, please. Bring it here. Okay, this is a normal text editor. You come on this text editor, you can see you can change here. I want to show you where you can change. You can change this this button, you can call it whatever thing you want. Maybe you can say my GUI. Then here also Python GUI, you can see this. That's something you have to change. If you're good at reading codes and you love typing codes, you are gonna do that. So these are the lines which going to create. You can see here we set the width and the height. You can see all those, whatever. There's something to be set here. Default size is going to be width, and the height, you can see that is what they tell you to set here. And each and every line here, window positioning is going to what to center, understand. So the button when is closed is what is created. Then they say self add here. You can realize that in Python we don't have those things like semicolon, is like where the way we use in Java, PHP, you know, all those things to end a line. So Python by itself, it will know that the line ends here. So you can read through the lines if you from a programming language, which any programming language is easier here to read some lines, even if it's the first time to look at this code. If you're from any programming language, you can know what is going on here. So that is done. So what you do, you save it. How many lines we have here? We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, whatever. Then you, what you're gonna do, you save. How do you save? You save this as what? We're gonna save it in my documents, whatever, whenever you want to save it. If you want to create a new folder, you can create a new folder. We can call it Python. Let's call it small letters Python. I know these are big letters, Python. Okay, GUI. Okay, we create it under documents, and inside documents we're gonna create a thing called test. Okay, then test dot py. Don't forget the py. Py means Python. As you can see, the extensions for HTML, it has to be .html, also for PHP, .php, all of that. So this is simply something like the same thing if you are a programmer. Even if you don't know nothing in programming, this is a good tutorial to start with. So then we save. After saving that, we find, you can see after saving, now the text editor, it shows us what we call a colors. So the change colors. So after changing colors, then that is good. Then you do what, we close that. So after closing, I'm gonna look for my, what they call my terminal. So once we go to terminal, then we can do and say, okay, come on, do this. It's gonna be sudo. I'm gonna say sudo su. Sudo su. I wanna make myself to be sudo. Then we say, okay. So we enter. After hitting our enter here, this is something good. Then what we're gonna do, we're gonna say cd to documents. 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 Okay. Remember our folder? /python GUI. We say enter. Okay, we in there. Then say ls. We're listing whatever is there. So we have what they call the test. So if you see that you have this test, what you're gonna do here, you're gonna say chmod minus r. It's gonna be, yeah, we're gonna give it some permissions there. I forgot. But I'm gonna show you simple things. You have to do things every day to not forget. See, is it minus R? I think it could be minus R. Then triple. Yeah, let me see. 577. Okay. Then you say dot test. If it fails, I know what to do. Okay. You wanna give this permissions. Give it permissions. Select, then save. Say okay. I guess that's done. Yeah, once it's done, it's fine. Okay, once it's done, then what you're gonna do, have you ever run a program from Android on Linux? This is simple. You say dot forward slash, you say test dot it has to be small. Let us test dot py, then you enter. You can see once you enter, then you can see your GUI is here. It says Python GUI, then after here it says GUI. This is the button which you have to press. So once you press that button, it gives you here hello world, hello world, hello world. So now we can also stop that, then we try to do customizing of our code. So once we come here, you remember we went to one of those folders whereby we have to say good. I'm gonna come in here and I look for Python GUI, my Python, no, leave that, Python GUI. Then here we can modify our thing here, whatever. Okay, whenever you press that button, it says this. You can see def when button one underscore clicked self button, then what, look what it says, it gives this and say we're gonna change this to say I'm here. Okay, if I say I'm here, okay, then after that we save our file. And okay, after saving, I guess that is so crazy. Okay, after saving that, we can go here and we look for our terminal. Where is the terminal? Once we got our terminal here, we can become sudo again, sudo, and we say su, enter, then we give it our password. Then it's enter. After that, we gonna do something like saying cd2. Can we recall the command recalled again? Let me see. No, we only have to. Okay, let's go documents. Then we say cd again to Python GUI. Then you say enter. Then you say dot. Okay, you can see when you hear, then you can list ls. Just I'm listing to see what is in there, but that command doesn't help us anything. Then say dot test, no dot fat slash test. Okay, test dot pu dot py. Then once you say that, you can see now it's there. Then I'm gonna start to click. It's giving me I'm here. Thanks for watching, guys. Don't forget to subscribe. This is so amazing. So in the next tutorial, we're gonna try to say to use graphic user interface, what programs to run. Like you can see, okay, let me talk about NetBeans. If you're using NetBeans in Java, you know the way you do your forms and stuff, you can drag and drop. So we're gonna use a program like that, but here we wanted to show you an introduction on something like that, because most people, they know they do Python for web, but Python does a lot of things, so it's a language to learn anyway. Thanks for watching, guys. See you in the next video, and don't forget to subscribe, because you're gonna get more on Python, more, I believe, and it's not a joke, you're gonna get more. So this is Azania Tutorials, guys.